Today's session is about Module 4, Session 2, Foot and its Constituent. So, initially we are having the opening. In the opening, we'll ask the students to get back the worksheets which they had done in the previous week. Once you collect back the worksheets, we'll be asking the question, what does the athletics do after they are done with the running? So, we are expecting the answer is glucose. Once the students say the glucose answer, so you'll be saying that glucose is the one which is being required to body, which provides energy. So once the facilitator tells that, later on we'll be saying that carbohydrates are the one which is containing glucose, which provides energy to our body. Once you share this answer, later on you'll be asking the students what happens if they don't have food for one day. Students share their answers. Once the students share their answers, the facilitator will be saying that, so the as if we don't have food for one day, the fats which are in our body will convert that into energy and helps the person to stay. So once the facilitator says that, later on we'll be saying that, we'll be telling the facilitator says that we'll be playing a game which is similar to that of the fruit salad. Here the facilitator will name the students like fish, milk, egg and almond. So once we name the students with these, so we will be telling the students that once the facilitator would call out any one food in this, so they have to exchange their places. Before exchanging, we have to say that they have to draw a circle around themselves. So this makes them messy, this controls them messy, where the students will not fall on each other. So once they are done, the facilitator calls out the food item, like example, fish. So all the students who are named as fish will exchange their places. So after that, the person who will be the last person to enter into the circle and he doesn't find any circle, he will come in the middle, or the student will come in the middle and calls out any other food name. For example, almond. So the students who are named as almond will exchange their places. The same continues. So once the facilitator or the student calls out lipids, everybody will exchange their places. This is how the game goes on. So once that is done, we'll be introducing the word lipids. So lipids is nothing but a substance. It is a substance which contains fats, oil or wax, which are insoluble in water. So you explain the definition of lipids. So lipids is a substance that contains fats, oils or wax that are insoluble in water. So once you are done, now we will be explaining the functions of the lipids by using the handouts, which is containing four handouts. It might be having that with lipids helps in the clotting of blood and such other things. So once you are done with that, we also tell us lipids and proteins are the energy giving foods. So once that is done, we are done with the opening. So next is the main creation. In the main creation, we have two parts. The first part of the main creation is, we will be playing a game which is called as word search. Here the facilitator will split the class into 10 groups or more or less, which is based on the strength of the classroom. So once you divide the class, each group will be given a handout which will be given the blank of word search. So the facilitator will be having a reference or the handout which will be having the description. The facilitator will call out one word. For example, here the facilitator will call out proteins. So students which will be having that word search, we will have to shade the word proteins in their sheet. So once they are done, the team which finishes faster will come to the facilitator and gives. So the team will get a chance to read the description of the proteins. Here the description for proteins is, proteins are made up of a set of 20 simple compounds called as amino acids. So that team will get a chance to read out the description. The same continues until you read out all the words in the sheet. So once that is done, the team which answers the correct word with the description will get 2 points. So the team which is the group which is having getting more number of the points will be winning the game. So once this game is done, the facilitator will brief out the description with the words. Once that is done, to get to know how much the students have understood, we will be playing another game that is called as a quiz. So here the facilitator will call out or can ask questions which is in the sheet, which is about the description of the word. Here the facilitator will frame the questions by using this handout. So facilitator asks the questions. The groups has to raise their hands. The group which raises the hand first will get a chance to answer the question. Once they answer the question, they get 5 points for each question. The group which answers most of the questions will be the winner of the game. This is the first part of the main creation. The second part of the main creation will be this. Here the facilitator will be asking what happens, what does digestion takes place in our body. So we'll be asking how the digestion process takes place in our body. Here will be the students share their answers. Once the students share their answers, we will next go. The facilitator says digestion occurs mostly in the intestine and rest few things in the stomach. So here the intestine is small intestine and large intestine. Later we will introduce the word which is called as fiber. So fiber is a substance in plants that are not digested by the human digestive systems. It is a substance which get not easily get digested in our body. And also we see that it is in the form of stool, and the undigested fibers will move to the other parts of the food in the digestive tract. And we also tell the sources of the fiber. Here the sources are plant origin, and these also includes fruits, vegetables, nuts, peas and legumes. And here the best part of the dietary fiber is in the form of grains. And we also ask why fiber is important to the students. They share their answers. Later on, the facilitator says that it helps to maintain the digestive systems and has most number of the calories. And fiber also helps in digesting from different parts like small intestine and large intestine. And it also helps to bulk to our tools and prevent the constipation also. And it also helps to healthy body weight and gives feelings of fullness. And it also helps to prevent us from overeating, that is obesity. And fibers would reduce the risk of heart diseases, diabetes and cancers. This is about the fibers. Once you are done with explaining the fibers, later on is the water. So in water, we say that it is very necessary for the production and the maintenance of the body. And it also helps to coat and lubricate the body, joints. And it helps to maintain the temperature of the body, like sweating from the skin. And it also helps to carry nutrients from the stomach to all the parts of the body to keep the body active. And it also helps to carry the oxygen from the lungs to the other bodies. Once you are done with explaining fibers and water, now we have a game which is card game. Here the cards, before giving them, the teams will be continuing. So the teams, each team will get a sheet that is about roughages and it's the sources and functions of the roughages and water. So here the students will get a time of 2 minutes where they had to read it. 2 or 5 minutes is fine. So you'll be giving them to read out. Each team gets his handout and they get 5 minutes. They read it, and once they are done, we'll take back the handout and we'll give them a deck of cards in which it is containing 14 cards in that. It is having a set of 14 cards. The cards will be regarding roughages and fiber. This way. This comes in a form of cards. Each sentence will be in one card. So this is how. So the each team will get these cards. What the students have to do is they have to arrange the sources and functions of roughages and fibers in an order. So they have to see the cards and they have to arrange what are the functions and the sources of roughages and what are the functions and sources of fibers. So once they are done, we'll be going to the closure. In the closure, the facilitator tells that they have to list down the different constituents of the food like proteins, vitamins, lipids and minerals. They have to make a separate columns using this. Like vitamins, minerals, proteins. So they had to make a separate columns. So they had to make a separate columns like this, and they had to write down the food which they consume for the next week will be having proteins every week. They had to note down which food they have will be containing vitamins, minerals, lipids and protein. For this the facilitator will distribute them A4 size sheet. So you just brief out them saying that they have to make a separate column like this. They had to list down the
items which they have in the next week will be containing vitamins, minerals, lipids and proteins. Once everything is done, just brief out the session which you have done in the class for that day. So this is the closure. Thank you. Meet you in the next week.